Good morning, Eagle Nation. It's Friday. It's the last Friday in April. It's also the 162nd day of school. It's 8:31 a.m. office standard time. Wherever you may be, please stop, please stand, and let us rise for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated on this Friday. Hope you're dressed for success so you can make it to the end. Thank you, students, for all your hard work this week on your Math AZM2. We appreciate all your effort and hard work. And sixth graders, we are with you today in spirit as you also give your best. It's the last day to get a yearbook. Click on the button below the link. Payment can be received later. Some of you have already paid, we appreciate that, but you gotta get yours in today if you're gonna get it at all. We will take the button down today at the end of the day. Think about it, don't be missing out. Also coming up next week is Teacher Appreciation Week. We have a song, a button below this to dedicate a song to a teacher. And teachers, you could dedicate a song to another teacher as well. Click the button, follow the directions. We hope that you do. Looking ahead to next week, May the 3rd, lots of stuff going on. Emerson is an artful place for peace, and we have a project that's been going on and will continue. Starting in December, Dr. Music, Ms. Ewan, and the Cultural Arts Coalition worked in partnership with the 5th and 6th graders in the following ways. Local artists each led students through an art activity and exploration of the Huichol culture in Mexico as it relates to their own art practice. Reggie Casillas demonstrated art in multiple ways. Then Gloria Martinez Granados introduced the art of beading. She came and students also worked with her to create their own beaded bracelets. Mr. Keith came and worked with 5th and 6th graders to teach the Manjani rhythm from West African countries, such as Senegal, Mali, Guinea, and the Ivory Coast, Cote d'Ivoire. Students played a Manjani song with three drumming patterns and a bell pattern. And then finally, Ms. Hamid came and taught a Manjani dance to the same students. Students learned how the dance is integral to West African culture and were able to compare rites of passage in their own cultures to the Manjani. So, in this way, we brought cultures from different continents and different peoples together, including visual arts and music and dance to celebrate humanity, to celebrate history, to celebrate connections and self-expression. We hope that you're a part of this too, and we've made a place for you to make that possible. So Student Council, thank you Student Council, and No Place for Hate, thank you No Place for Hate, have joined together. They're joining the coalition by sharing that coalition's amazing teachings with our whole school and community. They are eliciting each homeroom, that's all of you, to spend some time discussing how the arts can bridge cultures and peace. Homerooms will then decorate doors for a door decorating contest using the following guidelines. This is going to begin on the 3rd of May and end on the 11th of May. So, we ask that in some way, in your door decoration, the entire class participates. Second guideline, use symbols or words that represent peace. Third and final is to represent different cultures, music, art, or dance. And as you are different people, and each of you has your own unique culture that also comes from your very own household, it can be something that represents you through music, art, and dance. There will be two winners, one from K-4 and another from 5th through 8th. We'll have popsicles coming your way. Those are sponsored by Teen Court. So Teen Court, we thank you for that too. Lastly, as a part of this initiative, PTO is sponsoring a Dollar for Peace fundraiser to raise money for a peace pole that's going to be planted on Emerson School campus in fall. Peace poles are now the most recognized international peace symbol and monuments all over the world, with more than 200,000 of them standing in almost every country throughout the world. This fundraising will begin on Monday, May 3rd, and go until May the 11th. If every student and staff member donates just $1, in fact, it's capped at $1. You're not allowed to bring in more than $1. Every person we're asking to just bring $1, we will be able to purchase our very own peace pole. It's about 8 feet tall, it's got four sides on it, and it says in various languages, "May peace prevail on earth." Ours will include English, Spanish, Navajo, and sign language. On Friday, May the 14th, then, we will hold a virtual celebration ceremony and a peace pole presentation using a peace pole donated by the Cultural Arts Coalition. But students who are not in 5th and 6th grade will also get to see the dance, the music, and the artwork with our live stream presentation on that day. It'll be from 2:45 to 3:15 on Friday, May the 14th. But that celebration to close out our year begins on Monday, which, as you know, is also Teacher Appreciation Week. Be sure you thank your teachers. I'm gonna have some buttons for you students, so look back on this site on Monday so that you'll have a way to send a message specifically to a teacher, even if it's a teacher you haven't had yet or a teacher you've already had. We'll have a way for you to give your thanks and appreciation to them all. PBIS, let's close out the week on this Friday by being responsible, and our tip is one you've heard before, but it's a good one. Be responsible today by keeping your cameras on. Your teacher and friends want to know you are following along, and others, and you can do that when your cameras are on. We thank you in advance. Let's get to some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. Today is about bullying, but it's also about the golden rule and kindness. Listen to this American proverb. A bully is always a coward. Let's think about what that means. Have you ever noticed that bullies pick on people they think are smaller or weaker than themselves? It's true, they do. That's why being a bully is cowardly. It's a weak thing to do. Truly strong people are strong enough to be kind and respectful toward others, not mean and hurtful. So today, be the strongest person you are and be big enough to show kindness and respect to those around you. Treat others the way you would want to be treated. And if you find yourself being a bully, ask for help. With something to think about, this is Mr. Lodato. Make it a great day or not. The choice is yours.